My faith will move this mountain. Do it now. Come on.
My faith will move this mountain.
Yes, yes, yes.
My faith will move this mountain.
Say it, say it, say it.
My faith will move this mountain.
What about your praise?
My praise will move this mountain.
My shout.
My shout will move this mountain.
Do it, do it, do it, do it. Thank you for joining us today, everyone. And I pray today he would remove the veil of limitation as you come to him. Take away the veil. Take away the veil. Open up my eyes. Let me see your light shining in the night. Open up my eyes that I may see you face to face and touch your holy grace. Take away the veil. To hear. what I want you to do, everybody, all of you that have joined me, some of you just don't feel like doing this. Stop for a minute and just lift your hands up and join us. We all have our struggles. I'm also tired, but many of you need to just do this, because when you give, it shall be given to you. That's what I want you to do. I want you to give to God and ask Him this now. Take away the veil. There's a veil of limitation that rests upon you. It comes when you have fears, when you have misunderstandings. You have many broken things happening in your life. Let's just pray for Him to lift the veil so we can be open for Him to remove the strangulation and the paralysis in our life. Ready? Let's do verse 1.
Take away the veil. Take away the veil. Open up my eyes. Let me see your light shining in the night. Open up my eyes that I may see you face to face. Touch your holy grace.
Minister to right now. Just stop. Let peace come to you. pray that suffocation, oppression, suppression, depression, obsession, everything that squeezes the life out of your people would lift now. And we worship you as the breath of God. We worship you as the wind that brings the breath of life to man. That wind that blows where it wishes and performs these operations on your people quick and restores and renovates. Lord, somebody wrote in today and said, tell me how to encourage myself in the Lord. I took note of your request that you sent in. How do I encourage myself in the Lord? And that's what we're doing right now. We're worshiping God. Because you see, when you worship God, He reciprocates, which means He always responds to you with courage and strength. We all need it sometimes. We look to man and then we get nothing. They were about to kill David because he obeyed God. They were about to kill David because he wouldn't kill Saul. And yet David had to go one side and encourage himself. And the way I encourage myself is I remind myself, first of all, of what he's brought me through. I remind myself of the words that he's spoken over my life. And I take those words and I speak them to myself. Written throughout the Psalms, David would speak to his soul. And he would tell God, say to my soul, you are my salvation. He would predict the outcome of his situation and his circumstance. And he would say, be well, soul, for God will surely deliver you and bring you out of this mire. He would encourage himself by the power of prophetic insight, taking God's words and reminding him of what God has said and done over the years. Why don't you do that for a minute? Facing a situation, maybe. Take thought now of what you've been through before, how he helped you and delivered you before, and say to yourself, if he did it before, he'll do it again. He shall surely deliver me. So Lord, we approach the throne of grace knowing that you will hear us and deliver. And we give you thanks for that today. Amen.
Hi, I'm Jacqueline Clement. Thank you for watching our YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and you can find all the information about our ministry and my father in the description below. Thank you for watching with us today.